The Adrian College Sports Network wants you to join us in thanking one of our sponsors, the Carlton Lodge of Adrian. The Carlton Lodge offers a comfortable and convenient lodging experience. Carlton has spacious rooms and suites, fit for a peaceful night's sleep. Their amenities include a hot tub and pool, a 24-hour fitness center, a business center, and much more. A huge thanks to Adrian College's choice of lodging for sponsoring Bulldog Athletics.
Adrian College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
Hello, students. This is President Docking coming to you again from the President's Office at Adrian College. Hey, I'm sending you this video with some great news. Despite all that's been happening with the pandemic, COVID-19, etc., we've been hard at work on campus, and the faculty have recently approved eight new degree programs, which I think are super exciting. And I want you guys to know about these so you can start to think about them as you think about your future academic career here. So here they are. The first one is in public health. We have both a major and a minor now in public health. Can you think of a more relevant major than public health right now, given all that's going on? The second one is supply chain management. If you're following the news, supply chain management is really where it's at. There are thousands of jobs. I happened to look before I got in this video. Some of these jobs pay over $100,000 a year right out of college. Public health pays very well as well. Great area to go into. The third new major that the faculty approved is human resources. And you know, every business, I mean, whether it's Adrian College or IBM or something in between, has a human resource office. Lots of jobs, great field to go into. The fourth is professional sales. Now, whatever your professional career, you have to know how to sell, whether you're selling yourself, whether you're selling goods, whether you're selling services, whether you're selling your character. Professional sales is a great thing to be trained in academically. The next one is esports management. Now, esports is just absolutely exploding across the country. And I know we have a lot of students that are athletes that would like to stay into sports. So we now have an esports minor degree. It's a minor right now, may turn into a major later, but it's a minor right now that you can get your degree in. And then we have two certificates that we're now offering in digital marketing, which is incredible. I mean, digital marketing, again, whatever you're going into, if you can do some digital marketing, your employers will love it. So these are high skill, high pay, high need areas with literally thousands of jobs coast to coast. So long and short is, once again, Adrian's on the cutting edge. We're at the forefront. We are leading the pack in innovation and ingenuity. And we just wanted you guys to know all that's going on. So there you go. It's all good news today. I hope that brightened your day. Thanks for tuning in.
Are you looking to continue your athletic career while also pursuing your educational career? Adrian College houses dozens of varsity and club programs right here on campus, along with 77 undergraduate degrees and 47 majors. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
I'm kind of left speechless after that.
Thanks, guys.
representing the United States of America, Adrian.
Hey, there he is, Bruiser. Hi, I'm Bruiser's biggest fan. He was a legend to us puppies.
Strong but silent. Such a humble attitude from such a prominent figure.
He ran Adrian College's campus. Everyone loved him and wanted to meet him wherever he went. Welcome week, homecoming, spring concert. He was there and looking good. Well, he did have his own private groomer. He was so cool. He had the best education a bulldog could ever ask for, as many walks as he wanted. Heck, the dog had his own pastor, Richie. Bruiser was an athlete, but I'm so small. He did have to work hard at it. Well, maybe not too hard, but it will take a lot of commitment and practice. I want to land on varsity at Arrington too. It's just such a big jersey to fill. Seriously, huge. But I can do this. I want the job. Because I want to make thousands of Bulldog friends just like him. So hi, Adrian College. I'm Bruiser too.
Time I'd like to introduce President Docking.
16 years I've been doing this, saying hello to freshman groups coming in. But obviously this one's different. The friends that you're going to make, the experiences that you're going to have, the memories that you will create are just amazing.
The stars were burning so bright. Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. We're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13 to 1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here, meet mentors, and maybe even meet that special someone. The Kane Student Center is open 24 hours a day, and there's a lot going on here. The Bulldog Beanery has all of your hot drinks. Pause and Go is our on-campus convenience store. The bookstore is where you'll get all of your Bulldog gear, and you can just hang out and study in the skyboxes. Not far away is the Shipman Library. The Shipman has quiet, relaxing spaces for you to study in. You can check out books from thousands of libraries around the country, and the Shipman is open 24 hours as well for your convenience. There are hundreds of learning opportunities on campus. In addition to the arts and beautiful facilities, Adrian College is known for its athletic programs. There is nothing like a Saturday game day here in Adrian. The Bulldog football team are 11-time MIAA champions. At Docking Stadium, fans watch soccer, lacrosse, football, and more. Just a few hundred yards away, Adrian College's basketball teams compete. In addition to basketball, fans can enjoy wrestling, acro and tumbling, and volleyball here. We also have a state-of-the-art weight room available to all of our students. When things heat up too much on campus, you can cool off with our ice sports. Our NCAA ice hockey teams are constantly battling in the national playoffs. Just a quick walk down the service drive, we feature one of the best baseball and softball programs in the nation at our level. Soon, you'll be able to cross the street and watch men's and women's rugby take to the pitch as well. Our rowing, crew, and top-ranked bass fishing programs compete out of the Adrian College Boathouse, a gorgeous facility just a 15-minute drive north on Devil's Lake.
Maria is a double major in graphic design and biology with a minor in art history. Maria joined our D2 ACHA program during her freshman year, playing 2 years at forward and 1 year at defense before suffering a career-ending injury this past summer and becoming our student manager and social media liaison. During her 3 years on the ice, Maria played in 58 games, accumulated 34 goals and 15 assists for 49 points. As a student, Maria is a member of the National Society of Leadership and Success, Kappa Phi International Art Honor Society, and the Adrian College Art Club. After graduation, Maria plans on working as a medical ghostwriter, creating teaching materials for public health and education. Maria would like to end with, of course, I'm beyond thankful for my friends and family, but one person who I never really said thank you to in these 4 years was myself. I didn't have to finish college when I was struggling mentally or when I was in a wheelchair or still now when I am in constant pain from an injury, but I did it anyway. So good job to myself. I'm proud of you for making it. You're much stronger than you give yourself credit for. Let's give a round of applause for number 23, Maria Granger. Next up is number 12, Katie Hayward, forward from Livonia, Michigan. Katie is an exercise science major in a pre-professional program and minor in psychology. Katie has been a part of the team since her freshman year. During her 4 years of age in college, she has played in 67 games and has scored 59 goals and 28 assists for 87 points. Katie was also named CCWHA second team all season in 2020. Katie's dedication in the classroom has resulted in her being on the Dean's List and an ACHA All-Academic American in 2020. Katie will be graduating summa cum laude and will be continuing her education at Miami University to get her MS in kinesiology with a graduate assistantship. Katie leaves us with, to my parents, thank you for supporting my hockey career and being there for me whenever I needed it. To my teammates, thank you for giving me such a positive college hockey experience. I'll miss you all dearly. Let's give a round of applause for number 12, Katie Hayward. Is number 17, Kenzie Heisner. She's accompanied today by her mother, Karen, and her father, Tracy. Kenzie is a physical education major with a health minor. Kenzie has been a part of our program since her freshman year and has played in 68 games, scoring 29 goals and 21 assists, totaling 50 points. She was also named an alternate captain her junior year. Kenzie plans on becoming a physical education teacher after graduation and continuing to coach hockey. Kenzie leaves us with, Mom, Dad, thank you for everything you've done to get me here. You've been my best friends and biggest supporters throughout this entire ride. I love you both so much. And to Wash Up, thanks for always keeping things interesting. There's never been a dull moment with you ladies. I'll miss you all. And finally, a big thank you to the rig staff for teaching me to drive the Zamboni, for being so amazing and unbelievably kind to me these past few years. Let's give a round of applause for number 17, Kenzie Heisner. Next up is number 11, Britt Lauser, forward from Pepperall, Massachusetts. She's accompanied by her mother, Michelle. Britt is a criminal justice major and getting her master's in business administration. Britt joined us this year after playing 4 years on the D1 ACHA team. During her time with our D2 team, Britt has played in 7 games, scoring 4 goals and 5 assists for 9 points. After graduation, Britt plans on becoming a customs and border patrol agent. Britt leaves us with, thank you to my family, teammates, and coaching staff that have helped me develop to where I am today. The sacrifices my family has made to get me where I am today, I cannot thank you enough. Let's give a round of applause for number 11, Britt Lauser. Next up is number 1, Victoria Poland. She's accompanied by her mom, Maria. Victoria is a double major in criminal justice and philosophy. During Victoria's 4 years with the team, she's played 51 games, totaling 2,800 minutes, and a 905 save percentage to go along with a 2.47 goals against average.
Victoria's drive in the classroom is unmatched and well recognized as a member of the Motor Board, Alpha Chi, Honor Society, and the Dean's List. In her spare time, Victoria is a member of the Adrian's NCAA lacrosse team, the National Society of Leadership and Success, and the Alpha Sigma Alpha Sorority. After graduation, Victoria will be attending the University of New Hampshire School of Law. Victoria leaves us with, being on WASHA B2 has been a privilege, and I will always be grateful to my teammates and their parents for supporting me every step of the way. Let's give a round of applause for number one, Victoria Holden.
Class of the true number one, being the first class of seniors in program history. They had undefeated
2018-2019. This class will be greatly missed, and we appreciate all you have done for your teammates and coaches. The sacrifices you have all made as student athletes have set great examples for your teammates and future players to come. We are so excited to see what the future holds for each of you. If you could, please give another round of applause for the Women's D2 ACHA Senior Class.
In its 2021 edition of America's Best Colleges, U.S. News & World Report has once again ranked Adrian College as a top regional college in the Midwest. The institution was named to the Best Regional Colleges Midwest section for the seventh consecutive year, and once again listed number two in the Most Innovative Schools category. In addition to these honors, Adrian College was also named to the Best Undergraduate Teaching and Best Value College lists. Adrian College has been established as a distinctive and innovative educational leader in the United States. The institution places priority on a culture of innovation and critical thinking. This is the 12th consecutive year Adrian College has been featured by U.S. News & World Report. You can see the full list of rankings and find more information on their website. For more information about Adrian College, visit adrian.edu. If there was one word I was going to use to describe the communication arts program at Adrian College, it would be unique. Students find themselves on the radio, in front of and behind the camera, and directing their own programs. Students learn in a personalized environment that sets them up for a world of opportunities. Are you ready for your moment in the limelight? Learn more about the Rush Communications Center and Adrian College's communications program by visiting adrian.edu today.
Hello students, this is President Docking coming to you again from the President's Office at Adrian College. Hey, I'm sending you this video with some great news. Despite all that's been happening with the pandemic, COVID-19, et cetera, we've been hard at work on campus, and the faculty have recently approved 8 new degree programs, which I think are super exciting. And I want you guys to know about these so you can start to think about them as you think about your future academic career here. So here they are. The first one is in public health. We have both a major and a minor now in public health. Can you think of a more relevant major than public health right now, given all that's going on? The second one is supply chain management. If you're following the news, supply chain management is really where it's at. There are thousands of jobs. I happened to look before I got in this video. Some of these jobs pay over $100,000 a year right out of college. Public health pays very well as well. Great area to go into. The third new major that the faculty approved is human resources. And you know, every business, I mean, whether it's Adrian College or IBM or something in between, has a human resource office. Lots of jobs, great field to go into. The fourth is professional sales. Now, whatever your professional career, you have to know how to sell, whether you're selling yourself, whether you're selling goods, whether you're selling services, whether you're selling your character. Professional sales is a great thing to be trained in academically. The next one is esports management. Now, esports is just absolutely exploding across the country. And I know we have a lot of students that are athletes that would like to stay into sports. So we now have an esports minor degree. It's a minor right now, may turn into a major later, but it's a minor right now that you can get your degree in. And then we have 2 certificates that we're now offering in digital marketing, which is incredible. I mean, digital marketing, again, whatever you're going into, if you can do some digital marketing, your employers will love it. So these are high skill, high pay, high need areas with literally thousands of jobs coast to coast. So long and short is, once again, Adrian's on the cutting edge. We're at the forefront. We are leading the pack in innovation and ingenuity. And we just wanted you guys to know all that's going on. So there you go. It's all good news today. I hope that brightened your day. Thanks for tuning in.
Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. We're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13 to 1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people at home and abroad, and thank you for tuning in to Adrian College Television's live stream coverage of ACHA Women's D2 Hockey. You're in for a show this afternoon, as it's going to be the Michigan State Spartans taking on the Adrian College Bulldogs. Hi again, everybody. I'm Trey Matthews, and it is going to be a great day of hockey. It is senior day for this Adrian College Bulldog team. We are honoring the seniors, including Victoria Poland, Gabby Warwick, Katie Hayward, Tina Rotono, Hannah Roger, Kenzie Heisner, Haley Bigman, Liz Anderson, Hannah Chase, the captain, and Britt Leviser. So this is going to be an entertaining matchup, as this is going to be the final home game of the regular season for this D2 organization. So starting lineups are being presented. What I'm looking for this Adrian College Bulldog team is just to come out aggressive, come out guns blazing, and just try to get more shots on goal over the Michigan State Spartans. Their roster is going to be much smaller than this Adrian College Bulldogs. So I just listed off the seniors. There's going to be half the players on Michigan State's roster as opposed to Adrian College. So they have to take advantage of the tired legs for the Michigan State Spartans. Spoke to the Spartans head coach before the game. He told me, yes, it's going to be a small one, but don't underestimate us. We're going to be coming out aggressive. So starting lineups are being presented for the Adrian College Bulldogs, and we are going to step aside real quick on the Adrian College Television. But before we do, I just want to give a shout-out to all the seniors for their hard work, their determination, the blood, sweat, and tears to this organization, because there's been a lot of great storylines. Obviously, some parents can't be here in attendance due to borders being closed, but it's just a great ordeal for these seniors to be honored for their dedication and their hard work for everything they have done to this organization. They come out like a team, like a unit. It's a sisterhood. I remember seeing a project on this team during my digital media productions class produced by Rizzo, and he said, overall, they are really great. It's a really great organization, really great group of girls. Kathleen Droba spoke about it and just said it's an honor to be wearing the Bulldog uniform and just to be repping them each and every day. So with that, national anthem is about to be played, so we are going to step aside on Adrian College Television. I'm Trey Matthews, play-by-play announcer. Don't go anywhere.
Miss Constitution Day, the George W. Romney Institute for Law and Public Policy presented the annual Philip J. Perkowski Constitution Day Address on Adrian College TV this year.
His presentation, based on his extensive experience in the courtroom, promises to be revealing and thought-provoking. It's called Making the Words Matter: How All of Us, Not Just the Courts, Can Fulfill the Promise of the Constitution. Please join me in welcoming Brett DeGroff.
Using the arc of the moral universe, quote, too loosely carries with it a danger of magical thinking. Technically, we couldn't have expected the Constitution to do anything about it earlier. It was perfectly legal under the Constitution up to that point. The real action in this area is going to happen at the local level, in cities and in townships, because city and township governments fund and supervise police departments.
You can watch his revealing and thought-provoking speech now on Adrian College TV.
Adrian College is a pinpoint like no other. With our 77 undergraduate degrees, 47 majors, and 21 broad fields of study, Adrian has a one-of-a-kind, hands-on learning experience for everyone. Do you want to visit the campus of Adrian College in person? Visit adrian.edu/campus-visit. Again, that's adrian.edu/campus-visit. Come take in the beautiful facilities at Adrian College for yourself.
We continue to take pride and learn from Asa Mahan's leadership today. Years of commitment to harnessing the power of creativity, ingenuity, community, and academic excellence.
I believe that if you get your degree here, the world is going to feel like it's shrinking to you.
Welcome back to Arrington Ice Arena. If you're just tuning in, welcome. I'm Trey Matthews, the play-by-play announcer, and it's going to be a great afternoon for hockey as it's going to be the Adrian College Bulldogs taking on the Michigan State Spartans. Coaches going over their last-minute game plan with their respective teams near the benches, and we are about to get ready for the opening faceoff at center ice on Adrian College television. At starting netminder for the Bulldogs is going to be number one, the senior Victoria Poland from Rhode Island. And for the Spartans, it's going to be number 30, Lucia. Getting ready for the opening faceoff, and it's going to go to the Michigan State Spartans. Now back to the Adrian College Bulldogs as they have possession of it in their defensive zone, passing up the way to neutral zone. Spartans trying to go on the attack. Having possession of it right now is Poles. Poles going into the faceoff circle, lets one fire, and it goes a little too wide. Victoria Poland even need to make a stop on that. Goes into neutral zone. Bulldogs are going to have to come back and go on the attack. Rattles it around. Goes behind Victoria Poland. Having possession of it right now was Heisner. Poking at it in the southeast part of the rink. A lot of weak sticks right now. And it's going to go into the Bulldog zone as the Spartans just dump it in. Passing up ahead to Chase. Poke check away by the Spartans. Chase now has possession of it, looking to go on the attack, going past the blue line. It's going to bat off the leg padding of Lucia. Knifing at it below the goal line. Going in to the northeast corner. Droba trying to take possession of the puck. Off the skate of a Spartan player. Van Antwerp blocked out. Stevens has possession of it in neutral zone. Bulldogs are going to have to come back and reset. Passing it up to Britt Levasseur. Levasseur has possession of it now. One of the seniors for this team gets tripped up a little bit as she falls onto the ground. No penalties will be assigned. Bulldogs have possession of it now. Up to Hayward, past the blue line. Going deep into the slot. Let's one fire. She scores! Bulldogs will strike first here on Adrian College Television, and they will light the lamp for the first time this afternoon. Credit that goal to number 12, Katie Hayward. Let's look at the replay. Just right now having possession of it in neutral zone. Bulldogs were able to take possession of it, go deep into the zone. Hayward able to tip it in. Goes top shelf, bar down on the netminder for these Michigan State Spartans. So the Bulldogs are up 1-0 on Adrian College Television here at Arrington Ice Arena. Having possession of it right now is Zelminski. Poked away by Knapp. Now back over to Hayward. Chase has possession of it now. 2-on-1, odd man rush. Dropping it on back to Heisner. And having possession of it now are the Michigan State Spartans. Wogener is just going to dump it in. It's going to rattle around. Taking possession of it right now is Merriman. Bulldogs have possession of it now. Levasseur has it possession of it. Pass neutral zone. Pass the blue line. Going deep in the zone. Lets one fire. Knocked down by the Michigan State Spartans player. That was Massopos. Knapp pokes it away. Bulldogs have possession of it now. Offsides is the call. Unfortunately, Rybal got a little too antsy, went over the blue line before the Bulldogs were able to take full control of the puck in neutral zone. So we are going to try again with a faceoff in front of the bench for the Michigan State Spartans. And they are going to win the faceoff. Passing it around in their defensive zone, looking to go back on the attack. Garrett has it for the Spartans. And the Bulldogs are able to clear the zone. But the Spartans are hustling right now. Icing is the call. Defense got there first. So we are going to go back down the other way for a faceoff in the defending zone for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Faceoff is going to come, looks like on the stick side of Victoria Poland. Check that. It's going to be on the glove side in the southwest part of the rink. Faceoff goes to the Michigan State Spartans. London has possession of it, rattles it around, trying to pass it over to Robinson. Robinson loses possession of it, down in front of Poland, and London is able to just knock it away. Having possession of it is Scarborough, trying to pass it up ahead to Robinson. Puck a little too hot to handle. Having possession of it in their defensive zone is Garrett for Michigan State Spartans. Now in neutral zone, looking to go past the blue line. Having possession of it is Rowe. Rowe, too many Bulldogs there to greet her. So she is just going to hit it over to London for the girls in the yellow jerseys. Rybal has possession of it now, trying to pitch it up ahead to Droba. Can't get it to her, so it's going to go back to Gleiman. Gleim has possession of it for the Spartans, dropping on back to Paul. Back over to the Adrian College Bulldogs, wrestling for it now. 16-20 remaining in period number one. Bulldogs on top by a score of 1-0 here at Arrington Ice Arena. Levasseur able to poke check it away, taking it below Poland. She's going to charge up the way of the rink. Up ahead is the alternate captain, Heisner, to help her out. She's going to dish it on back, trying to go back door. And it goes a little too wide, but Heisner is there to help Levasseur out on the rebound, so she's going to dish it on back to Levasseur. Centering out front. And looks like Lucia is going to land onto the puck. Freeze action. We're going to get ready for a faceoff with 15:56 remaining in period number one. Bulldogs on top by a score of 1-0 here on Adrian College Television. Faceoff is going to come in the northwest side of the rink. Below the goal line, Levasseur trying to fish it out. Droba has possession of it now. Van Antwerp is there to help her out. It's going to go out of the zone. Olive Stevens is going to have to wait for her teammates to come back to neutral zone and reset. Heisner has possession of it now. A lot of Spartans there to greet her, and they're able to poke it away. Muscles it over to Wagner. Van Antwerp has possession of it now at the point area for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Droba trying to look for some space. Going deep in the zone. Tries to go through the 5-0. She scores! Lucia thought she was able to hold on to the puck. Unfortunately, Droba was able to go 5-0. And it's 2-0 for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Let's take a look at the instant replay. Droba just skating around in the attacking zone for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Went deep into the zone, able to go to the backhander out in front of Lucia. Again, Lucia thought she had full grasp of the puck. Unfortunately, it just went past her legs. So we are going to try again at center ice for a faceoff. Bulldogs on top by a score of 2-0 with 15-10. Remaining in period number one. Playing in front of the benches. It's going to go back over to the Michigan State Spartans in their zone. And holding on to it, so we're going to reset with a faceoff. Faceoff coming in the north side of the rink. Centering try. Off the faceoff. Lets one fire. Too much traffic in the lane, and the Spartans are able to knock it down. But going back into the possession of the Adrian College Bulldogs, wrestling for it now is Poles. And it's going to go back on down to Regner. Regner trying to fish it out. It's in the southwest corner. Northwest, excuse me. Knapp dumps it in to the Michigan State Spartans. Rowe has it. Now back over to Knapp. Back down to Wagoner. They're going to have to try to get out of their own zone. Bulldogs able to pitch it into their defensive zone. Knapp has it, trying to clear it. Passing up ahead to Regner. Regner lets one fire. And it's knocked down. Wore that puck. Excellent was the Spartan defender. Goes into the northwest corner here at Arrington Ice Arena. Fishing it out. Goes into neutral zone. Hayward rocking some blue hair for this Adrian College Bulldog team, known for her crazy hairstyles. Great way to express yourself. Regner. And centering over to Powell's for Michigan State. Now it's going to go back down to Bigman. Bigman, Scarborough, there to greet it. Skating around the south side of the rink. Goes into neutral zone. Knocked down by Chase. Wrestling for the puck, and it's going to be muscled over to Wagoner. We have 13:25 remaining in period number one. Shots on goal differential, 5-0 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Victoria Poland still has not seen a shot this entire period. Let's one fire off the leg padding for Lucia. Scarborough has possession of it. Centering try goes into the northeast corner. There on the rebound, Bigman has possession of it at the point area. Gets tripped up a little bit. Knifing at it was Rautanen. And the Bulldogs are just knocking it down. Goes into neutral zone. Line change for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Going back down to Victoria Poland. In the defending zone for the Adrian College Bulldogs, having possession of it is Stevens. She's going to skate through neutral zone, past the blue line, has speed right now. Lets one fire, goes a little too wide and a little too high. So wide of the post and high of the crossbar for Lucia to do anything with it. Back below the goalie line, over to Stevens. Stevens, weak stick, just dumps it in. Crawford has possession of it for the Michigan State Spartans. Rattles it around. Trying to center off for a shot. Too much traffic in the lane for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Trying to get there on the rebound. Anderson has possession of it. Centering try once again. Stevens there on the rebound. Too much traffic in the lane once again. Backed up. Rybel has possession of it. Dropping it on back to Stevens. Stevens trying to skate down deep into the slot area, but shut down by the Michigan State Spartans. And they have possession of it now. Rowe has it for the Michigan State Spartans. That's their first shot on goal. It's going to go off the leg padding of Poland. Rybel swiped away by Powell's. Gets tripped up right there. And, yep, offsides is the call. Got a little too antsy right there. 11:37 remaining in period number one. Bulldogs on top by a score of 2-0 here at Arrington Ice Arena. Again, it is senior night for this Bulldog roster, honoring the seniors for their hard work, dedication, blood, sweat, and tears. Coming in front of the penalty box for the Adrian College Bulldogs, and it's going to go back to the Bulldogs of Adrian. Heisner has possession of it now, passing up ahead, rattles it around. There to grab it is Knapp. Knapp has possession of it now. Traffic in the lane once again. Having at the point was Powell's. Now she's going to try to go back onto the attack for the Adrian College Bulldogs, but Britt Levisser had different ideas. She swipes it away. Knapp able to dish it off ahead to Heisner. Puck a little too hot to handle off the skate of Heisner. Past the blue line. Trying to go deep into the slot, but excellent poke check by Garrett for the Spartans. Bulldogs trying to take advantage of this tired Spartans team. Remember, they are having a small roster with them right now. Levisser has possession of it now. One-on-one, odd man rush. Goes a little too wide. 10:45 remaining in period number one. Shots on goal differential 6-1 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Knapp has possession of it now. Over to Heisner. At the point area. All alone. Zeminski lets one fire. Blocked down in front. Blocked again by Garrett. Excellent defense for the Spartans. Bulldogs are going to dump it in as there's going to be a line change. 10:20 remaining in period number one. Bulldogs on top by a score of 2-0. London has possession of it now in neutral zone. Clanking off the boards, and it's going to go back on down to Massopos. Massapos has possession of it now below the goal line of Lucia. Paul loses possession of the puck, swiped away by the Andrew College Bulldogs, all alone. Centering try, lets one fire, goes high of the crossbar, and a little too weakly to do anything with it. Having possession of it now is Hayward. Lets one fire at the point with a slap shot. It's going to go back into neutral zone for the Adrian College Bulldogs, trying to clear it. Hayward has possession of it now, taking it to the defensive zone for the ladies in the yellow and black jerseys. Going back to the girls in green and white. Massopost passing up ahead to Powell's, but they're being swarmed by great defense by the Adrian College Bulldogs. Lotek loses possession of it. So if you're wondering why Lotek is rocking a nameless number 14 jersey, it's because a few weeks ago in their game against Aquinas, she got hurt really bad during a play and actually had to have her jersey cut off as she had to be transferred over to the hospital. So normally she would be rocking number 5, but today she is rocking number 14 and nameless. And it's just nice to see her back on the rink for this Adrian College Bulldog team. The injury was scary, but ultimately doctors did a great job. Training staff here at Arrington Ice Arena and Adrian College did an excellent job to make sure that she could get back on the rink this year for the Adrian College Bulldogs as Poland holds on to the puck. And we are going to get ready for another faceoff in the defensive zone for the Adrian College Bulldogs. As looks like Poland and Stevens are just exchanging some words. Getting ready for the faceoff in the southeast corner. Lose possession of the puck. Stevens has possession of it now. Clanks it off the boards. Number 18 of Borbala has it for the Michigan State Spartans. Stevens trying to fish it out. One-on-one, lets one fire. She shoots it in and she scores! Fooled Poland right there was Wagoner. And the Michigan State Spartans are on the board. They cut this lead in half. It's 2-1 with 8:19 remaining in period number one. Let's look at the replay. Spartans had their best attack of the game, was able to fool the defenseman for the Adrian College Bulldogs, and was able to just do a nice deke to fool Victoria Poland as the puck went past her. So it is 2-1 here in period number one with 8:15 remaining in the first period of regulation. Heisner has possession of it now for the Adrian College Bulldogs, looking to do a tick for tack. And looks like holding on to the puck is Lucia. Line shift for the Michigan State Spartans as we're going to get ready for a faceoff in the north side of the rink. And it's going to go to the Adrian College Bulldogs at the point area. Leviser passing around. Knapp has possession of it now, trying to help out her teammates. Leviser lets one fire. Goes a little too wide. Excellent, strong shot. But not enough trajectory on it. Spartans have possession of the puck now. Zelminski there to greet him. Able to knock the puck away. Poles has it. Goes outside of the blue line into neutral zone, so the Spartans are going to have to come back and reset. They're just going to dump it in. Having possession of it now is Zelmanski. Droba taking possession of it now in the southwest corner. Knapp has possession of it now below the goal line. Clanks it off the boards. Trying to fish the puck out, as it is jammed right now. It's going to go back to the Spartans. That's their captain, Massopos. Hands it off ahead. Droba able to swipe it away as she's looking to have a full head of steam. She's already scored this game, trying to drop it on back to Leviser, but unfortunately nothing doing as the Spartans had different ideas. Having possession of it now is Paul. London has it for the Adrian College Bulldogs as she just knocks it over to the captain, Massopus, for the Spartans. Merriman. Rowe loses it. Glim. Back over to number 20, Jayev. Centering try over to Rogner, but nothing doing. Goes below the goal line. Having possession of it now is Glim. 6:05 remaining in period number one. Shots on goal differential, 8-3 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs, and they are ahead 2-1, and we are going to get a whistle. Looks like tripping is going to be the call, and being assigned to it is number 16, the senior Hannah Regner. So for the first time this afternoon, we're going to have a team in the power play opportunity, and the Bulldogs roster is going to shrink by one. Unfortunately, looks like Regner's skates got underneath the skates for the Michigan State Spartans, so that's going to result in a tripping minor each time. So, two-minute minor for the Adrian College Bulldogs, and looking to capitalize on the man-up advantage are the Spartans in green and white. Face-off coming in the southwest of the rink. Stevens has possession of it now, looking to clear the puck. And they're going to pass it up ahead to Massapos, able to stop it. Looking to collapse the defense are the Michigan State Spartans. Able to maneuver it. Levasseur looking for the puck, and she's able to clear the puck, and that's going to kill some time. 90 seconds remaining in the power play for the Spartans. Massapos has possession of it now, passing up ahead to Rowe. Rowe loses possession of her teammate. So Vanna Torp has possession of it now. Below Victoria Poland, rattles it around, trying to dish it over to Levasseur. Going deep into the slot area, centering try. Knocks it down. Too much traffic in the lane for the Spartans to do anything with it. Wagner has possession of it now. She's already scored this game for the Spartans. Trying to knock it down are the Adrian College Bulldogs. 1 minute remaining in the power play for the Spartans of Michigan State. Wagner has possession of it now. Over to Stevens. Stevens looking to clear the puck. She doesn't do so as it's going to go into neutral zone. Levasseur trying to poke it away. Chase able to sweep it and able to clear it and kill some time. 40 seconds remaining in the power play for the Spartans. Trying to capitalize on the man-up advantage. Creeping in is Heisner. And able to clear it once again are the Adrian College Bulldogs. 30 seconds remaining in their penalty kill. Having possession of it now is Garrett. Garrett's past neutral zone, past the blue line. Going deep into the zone, able to knock it away as Knapp and hits it over to Victoria Poland, who makes a nice grab and a nice save. Could have been trouble, but excellent defense by Knapp and a better save by Victoria Poland. So we are going to try again with the faceoff in the south side of the rink. 4:14 remaining in period number one. 13 seconds remaining in the power play for the Michigan State Spartans. Rattles it around. Off the skate of the Michigan State Spartans. They are running out of time. And the Bulldogs are going to come out victorious in their penalty kill. And the Bulldogs are back at full strength as Regner checks back into the game after serving time for her tripping minor. Tries to get a shot off, and it's a direct strike at Lucia. So we are going to have the teams do a line change, and a face-off will be coming in the north side of the rink with 3:52 remaining in period number one. Northwest corner going over to the captain, Massopos. Passing up ahead. Losing possession of it now was Wagner. Goes in to the south side of the rink. Fishing for the puck. Wagner has possession of it now. Demanding for the puck was Rowe. And 2-on-1, odd man rush. This could be trouble. Bulldogs passing it around. They're on the rebound. They can't get anything with it. Goes off the leg padding of Lucia. Way to keep the composure. Back at the point, lets one fire. Knocked down. And the Spartans are able to clear it. Now going back down the other way. 2-on-1 right now. Off the leg padding of Victoria Poland, and it gets knocked away. Hitting for the puck. Scarborough loses possession of it now, but London is able to regain control of the puck regardless. Passing up ahead. 3 on 2. And the Spartans are able to knock it down. And we are going to get a whistle. Looks like someone used their hand on the puck. So line change for both respective teams. With 2:44 remaining in period number 1. And we are going to try again with a faceoff. Shots on goal differential 9-5 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Adrian College has possession of it now. Tries to go for the backhander. Went for a backhander shot and was still relatively far away from the crease, but Lucia was able to hold on to the puck. And we are going to try again with 2:38 remaining in period number 1. Faceoff coming in the northeast side of the rink at the point area. Dumps it in was number 5 for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Wrestling for the pucks along the boards. Puck is going down the other way. Powell's has possession of it now. Stevens is able to swipe it away. Stevens trying to pass it up ahead to Druba. Druba able to maneuver it over to Hayward. Hayward lets one fire on the rebound. They score! That was just bad luck right there. Britt Levasseur gets another goal for this Adrian College Bulldog team. They lead 3-1. 2:07 remaining in period number 1 at the replay. Levasseur going deep into the zone, let one fire. Lucia bobbled off her padding and unfortunately went right behind her. That's just bad luck right there. So Britt Levasseur, the native from Massachusetts, makes this a 3-1 game with 2 minutes remaining in period number 1. Speaking of goals, Britt Levasseur played her first 4 years at Adrian College for the ACHA Women's D1 program under Brett Berger and Hannah Griffin, joining this ACHA D2 program during her 5th year while she's trying to obtain her master's in business administration. Now, Britt Levasseur was just 4 goals away from breaking the ACHA Women's D1 record. She had 65 career goals for the Adrian College D1 organization and was just trailing Kaylee Hardy by 3 goals and just needed 4 to break it. But I'm sure she's having a great time for this D2 program, and they are glad to have her right now as she has been putting up a great amount of points in just limited games played. Playing it out in front, trying to get there on the rebound. They score once again! 4-1 Adrian College Bulldogs. Absolute bedlam in front of the crease. And it looks like being credited with the goal is Hannah Regner, another senior. Looking at the replay, Bulldogs and Spartans were just tussling and wrestling for the puck in front of Lucia. Unfortunately, she got a little too flustered, and the puck was able to just go right past her. On the rebound for the Adrian College Bulldogs, they make this 4-1. We have 1:15 remaining in period number 1. Chase has possession of it. Knocking it away, goes ahead to Wagner. Rattles it around. Scarborough able to knife at it. Trying to jab it up ahead. Adrian College Bulldogs wrestling for it. Trying to go through the 5-hole. Victoria Poland, but she's able to put a glove on it. Victoria Poland exchanging some words, getting a little feisty. Saying, I held on to the puck. Stop trying to shoot it in. Looks like that was Poland and Rowe exchanging some words. They are being separated. And heading to the penalty box will be Bigman. It looks like slashing is the call. So for the second time this evening, it's going to be actually a double whammy as Wagner is going to be spending time in the penalty box as well for the Spartans. So it's going to be 4-on-4 hockey here at Erickson Ice Arena. It was absolute chaos in front of Poland as she was getting frustrated Referees had to separate, and they just said, you know what? We're done. Both of you head to the penalty box. So 4-on-4 hockey. Neither team is at full strength, but neither team will be in the power play, as there's miscommunication amongst the Michigan State Spartans as to who should be on the rink right now, delaying the game right now, trying to pass it up ahead to Brent Levisser, who's already scored this game. 44 seconds remaining in period number one. Jabbing it over to a Chase. Chase trying to slap it off. Stevens has possession of it now. Hits nothing but air. Van Antwerp has possession of it now. So if you're keeping track at home, Bigman is spending time in the penalty box for roughing. And Poland will land onto the puck as she lands onto her stomach. So Levisser right now exchanging words with the alternate captain, Powells, for the Michigan State Spartans. They are being separated. No, excuse me, that's Rowe. And Levisser heads to the penalty box. Looks like that's a hooking call. No, a high stick, excuse me. So 4-on-3 hockey, you don't see that too often. And we have 18.3 seconds remaining in period number one. So if you're keeping tabs at home, right now Bigman is spending time in the penalty box for the Adrian College Bulldogs for the next 90 seconds due to roughing. And Wagner is spending time in the penalty box for slashing. And Levisser is spending time in the penalty box for high sticking. And clearing it right now. And that's going to wind down. So to begin period number two, we're going to have an interesting setup between both respective teams, as it's going to be 4-on-3 hockey. And coaches are going to have their work cut out for them as they are heading to the locker room to get ready for the start of period number two. Bulldogs on top by a score of 4-1. All offense for the Adrian College Bulldogs. And it took a while for the Spartans to get their first shot on goal. But they are not out of it quite yet. They just got to be a little more aggressive and just clean up, just trying to get the rebound, corral it, and just trying to clear the zone and just try to go back on the attack if they want any chance to try to win. Because if I know anything about calling women's D2 hockey, is usually it's a high-scoring affair between both respective teams. And right now, it's looking that way right now as the Bulldogs are on top by a score of 4-1. And we still have two periods of hockey left, so we have 30 minutes remaining of just this great matchup between the Spartans and the Adrian College Bulldogs this afternoon. Right now, Spartans are slow to go back to the locker room. Adrian College Bulldogs just waiting it out, exchanging some words. And we are going to step aside here on Adrian College Television. I'm Trey Matthews, the play-by-play announcer. Joining me is Caitlin, the director. And we will catch you at the start of period number two. Don't go anywhere.
Kibby, the current student body president here at Adrian College. I chose AC because the campus simply feels like home. Everywhere I go, I know the amenities are there to help me succeed and get to the next level in my career. If you want to see what Adrian College has to offer, you can schedule an in-person visit at adrian.edu/campus-visit.
Bulldog fans, connect with Adrian College TV on social media to be updated when we're broadcasting live, to see highlights, plays of the week, and much more. Adrian College Television is on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. ACTV's handle is at Adrian College TV on every form of social media. Thank you for tuning in and subscribing to the home of the Bulldogs, Adrian College TV.
Adrian College is looking for leaders, student athletes with the tenacity to keep the Bulldogs at the top, the forefront, in and out of the classroom. The Bulldogs are looking for talent, character, hard work, grit, leaders who can electrify sold-out crowds, got out a last-line shift, will their team to victory, hit a grand slam in the bottom of the ninth, and be a part of a legend in the making. Think you have what it takes to become a Bulldog? Visit adrian.edu to learn more.
shot set in by MT, but she scores! And Adrian with a dream start in the finals of the MIAA tournament.
I don't even know what we say about it. Like, I'm kind of left speechless after that.
Next on ice, representing the United States of America, Adrian College.
Did you miss Constitution Day? The George W. Romney Institute for Law and Public Policy presented the annual Philip J. Perkowski Constitution Day Address on Adrian College TV this year.
His presentation, based on his extensive experience in the courtroom, promises to be revealing and thought-provoking. It's called Making the Words Matter, How All of Us, Not Just the Courts, Can Fulfill the Promise of the Constitution. Please join me in welcoming Brett DeGroff.
Using the arc of the moral universe, quote, too loosely, carries with it a danger of magical thinking. Technically, we couldn't have expected the Constitution to do anything about it earlier. It was perfectly legal under the Constitution up to that point. The real action in this area is going to happen at the local level, in cities and in townships, because city and township governments fund and supervise police departments.
You can watch his revealing and thought-provoking speech now on Adrian College TV.
In its 2021 edition of America's Best Colleges, U.S. News & World Report has once again ranked Adrian College as a top regional college in the Midwest. The institution was named to the Best Regional Colleges Midwest section for the seventh consecutive year, and once again listed number two in the Most Innovative Schools category. In addition to these honors, Adrian College was also named to the Best Undergraduate Teaching and Best Value College lists. Adrian College has been established as a distinctive and innovative educational leader in the United States. The institution places priority on a culture of innovation and critical thinking. This is the 12th consecutive year Adrian College has been featured by U.S. News & World Report. You can see the full list of rankings and find more information on their website. For more information about Adrian College, visit adrian.edu. In its 2021 edition of America's Best Colleges, U.S. News & World Report has once again ranked Adrian College as a top regional college in the Midwest. The institution was named to the Best Regional Colleges Midwest section for the seventh consecutive year, and once again listed number two in the Most Innovative Schools category. In addition to these honors, Adrian College was also named to the Best Undergraduate Teaching and Best Value College lists. Adrian College has been established as a distinctive and innovative educational leader in the United States. The institution places priority on a culture of innovation and critical thinking. This is the 12th consecutive year Adrian College has been featured by U.S. News & World Report. You can see the full list of rankings and find more information on their website. For more information about Adrian College, visit adrian.edu.
Welcome back to Arrington Ice Arena, where we're about to start period number two. Players, coaches, and referees ready to get going after resting, rehydrating, and refueling behind the scenes. And we are about to get ready for the opening faceoff to begin period number two. Hi again, everybody. I'm Trey Matthews, play-by-play announcer. With me is my director, Caitlin Parisi, and also Delaney Harris running top cam, her first game for Adrian College Television. Welcome to the family. So if you missed period number one, it's actually going to be very interesting to begin period number two because we're actually going to get 4-on-3 hockey. So the Spartans are in the power play, and the reason they are in the power play is because Britt Levisser is going to be spending the next minute and 42 seconds for high sticking. Bigman is going to be spending the next minute and 9 seconds due to roughing, and Wagner is going to be spending the next minute and 9 seconds with Bigman due to slashing. So a lot of penalties right now, but 4-on-3 hockey, it's going to be intriguing. Lucia and Poland will swap positions. Poland will be in the north side of the rink, and Lucia will be in the south side of the rink. Three players, two for the Bulldogs, one for the Spartans, heading back to the penalty boxes. And 20 minutes has been put up onto the board as we are about to begin period number two. Still 40 minutes of hockey to be played, so it's going to be intriguing. And false start right now. Yep, there was five players on the ice for the Michigan State Spartans. It is 4-on-3. little bit of a miscommunication right there. Probably forgot about the specialty teams. Going past the blue line, having possession of it is Rowe. Looking to collapse the three-man defense for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Stevens has possession of it now. Rattles it around. It's going to go back to the point area for Massopost, the captain. Pitching it over to Garrett. Garrett passing it on down. Let's one fire. Can't get through the leg padding of Victoria Poland as it bobbles off her. 38 seconds remaining in the penalty for Wagner and Bigman. Stevens has possession of it now, trying to clear the puck and blast it down to the other side of the rink. She does so. That's going to kill some time. It clanks off the southwest part of the rink. Having possession of it now is Garrett. Garrett is just going to tap it over to herself. Lays it on back to Heisner. Massopost has possession of it now. Gliding past the blue line. Goes below Victoria Poland. And Bigman and Massopost will check back into the game. So it is 5-on-4 hockey as Levister still has 30 seconds remaining in her penalty. So Spartans have 20 seconds to try to capitalize on their man-up advantage. But this could be trouble, trying to go on the odd man rush, but the puck was a little too hot to handle for the Adrian College Bulldogs, and able to just get possession of it and tap it on back were the Michigan State Spartans. Van Antwerp just knocks it ahead. Knocks it over. Clearing the zone. Levisser is back into the game, so we are back to 5-on-5 hockey here at Arrington Ice Arena. Spartans could not capitalize on that power play opportunity. Lotick able to knock it off and able to clear the zone. It's going to go back over to the Spartans in their defensive zone, however, and they're able to just hit it up ahead. Shifts it on back. It's going to go over to Paul. Paul is able to slide it over to one of her teammates, clanks it off the board. Poland waving her hand, warning her team of the icing, and Stevens gets there first to defense for the Adrian College Bulldogs. So we're going back into the defensive zone for the Michigan State Spartans to get ready for the faceoff. 17:43 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs on top by a score of 4-1 here at Arrington Ice Arena on Adrian College Television. Thank you for tuning in. Lotick has possession of it now. Goes between the legs of Rotundo. Centering try, shoots it in. They're on the rebound. Can they get the back end? Or they do. It could go in. Absolute bedlam in front of the crease. It looks like the netting got messed up a little bit. Nope, still intact. There was a Michigan State Spartan on her stomach behind Lucia. So that was really interesting to see. Never seen that before in a hockey game, where I see a player behind the netminder trying to prevent the puck from going in. Laying it on back to Zalminski. Knocking it off her leg padding. And it's going to go back to the Adrian College Bulldogs as they're trying to knife at it. Playing it along the eastern part of the boards. Lucia is going to hold on to the puck, freeze action, and we'll reset with a faceoff. With 17:13 remaining in period number two, Bulldogs on top by a score of 4-1 here at Arrington Ice Arena. Faceoff coming on the stick side of Lucia in the far side corner near the bench for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Back at the point area for Knapp. Knapp dumps it over to number 20, which is Jio. Couldn't capitalize right there. Centering try once again. Able to knock away are the Michigan State Spartans, but only momentarily as the Bulldogs regain control of it. Knifing at it. And poke checking away are the Michigan State Spartans. Having possession of it is Rowe. She passes up ahead. It's in neutral zone. Bulldogs are going to swipe it away. Going past the blue line, Jayov has possession of it, but is greeted by a bunch of players in green jerseys. Centering try over to Hayward, and the Spartans are able to swipe it away. Goes into neutral zone. Past the benches, past the blue line. Spartans have possession of it, looking to reset. Having control of it right now is Poles. Able to hit it away was Regner. And the Spartans are going to dump it in as there's going to be a line change. With 16:15 remaining in period number two. Shots on goal differential 18-11 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Regner has possession of it now. Past the blue line. looking for one of her teammates. She's going to lay it on back to London, excuse me. Robinson there to help her out. And the puck is on the stomach of a Spartans player. Looks like that was Kirkman, number 26. 15:58 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs still on top by a score of 4-1. They have more shots on goal, so it results in more goals. Also been on the attack longer than the Michigan State Spartans in their zone. Resetting with a faceoff in the southeast corner. Scarborough, slap shot, direct strike at Lucia. Holds on to it. Scarborough with a strong drive. Fortunately, couldn't get it through. 15:53 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs still on top by a score of 4-1. Face off in the southeast part of the rink. Knocks it on down to Garrett. Garrett loses possession of it now. Rattles it around. Having possession of it is number 21, Anderson, for the Bulldogs. Was able to just hit it over to one of her teammates. Centering try. And the Spartans are able to swipe it away. Referee's hands are in the air. Lucia is racing off the ice. So once the Bulldogs touch the puck, they are going back into the penalty. Spartans have the extra skater. Bulldogs finally touch the ice. Touch the puck, excuse me. Looks like hooking is the call on Scarborough. Unfortunately, you cannot stop skating and use your stick to tug on the opponent. That will result in a 2-minute hooking each time. Hook that player like a fish. Face-off is going to be coming in the north side of the rink with 15:22 remaining in period number two. And looks like also heading to the penalty box is Rybal. And it's going to be a 4-minute penalty. So this is trouble for the Adrian College Bulldogs. No, excuse me. Rybal's penalty will only be for 2 minutes, not 4 minutes. That's a mistake on the scoreboard. Faceoff is going to be coming in the northeast corner. And it is 5-on-3 hockey. You do not see that too often. Bulldogs are going to have to keep their composure and do whatever it takes to guard Poland in the crease area because it'll be easy for the Spartans to collapse the defense down low. So Bulldogs, they are going to have to clear the zone quickly. So Scarborough is in the penalty box for roughing and Rybal is in the penalty box for hooking. So it's a double whammy for the Adrian College Bulldogs. And right now, 90 seconds remaining in the power play for the Spartans. They have a golden opportunity to try to cut the lead in half. Knocks it off the padding of Victoria Poland. Goes in to the northwest corner. Now back at the zone. Lets one fire. Goes a little too wide. Bulldogs able to corral the rebound, and they are unable to clear the puck, as the Spartans are going to continue to pass the puck around to try to look for an opening. 14:10 remaining in period number two. Whistle is called as Poland lands onto the puck. So we are going to try again with a face-off. Line change of specialty teams for both respective teams. 57 seconds remaining in Rybal and Scarborough's penalty. Scarborough for roughing and Rybal for hooking. 14:15 remaining in period number two. Spartans have possession of it. Knocks it down there on the rebound. Able to knock it away. Poland a little vulnerable right now, but able to get back to her position quickly. Wasting some time. Garrett corrals the puck. Trying to skate through neutral zone past the blue line. Pestering her was Leviser. It looks like we're going to get another penalty as Lucia is hustling off the rink. Will this be something? 5-on-2 in all of my games of calling hockey. I've never seen a 5-on-2. Poland holds on to the puck. This is definitely trouble for the Adrian College Bulldogs. And it looks like it's going to be body checking. And in the penalty box is going to be Zelmanski. Van Antwerp and Poland discussing some words. So still 5-on-3. Excuse me. But there are three girls in the penalty box for the Adrian College Bulldogs, but Scarborough and Rybel will be checking in about 5 seconds. Barton's passing it around. Rybel checks back into the game. And Scarborough also hustles back to the bench. In neutral zone, knifing at it. Passing it around. 5-on-4. Hayward has possession of it now. It seems like the Spartans have been on the power play forever, but they have not been able to capitalize on anything. Still 4-1, 12:50 remaining in period number two. And Poland will hold on to the puck. Now Scarborough checks back into the game. So the Spartans have about 90 seconds remaining in their respective power play. And if they are being given golden opportunities to try to score and cut the lead in half, but still coming up empty. Faceoff coming in the north side of the rink on the stick side of Victoria Poland. Puck is bobbled. Goes back to the Spartans in their defensive zone. Having possession of it now is Ramsey. Bulldogs have possession of it now in their defensive zone. Now back on down to the Spartans as the Bulldogs are able to clear it. Masopus has possession of it. Passing up ahead. London is going to waste some more time. 53 seconds remaining in this penalty kill for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Past the blue line. Able to clear it once again is London to kill some more time. And that was close to being an offsides for the Michigan State Spartans, but the Bulldogs were able to swipe it away quickly. Kirkman has it for the Spartans, able to rattle it around, playing in front of the benches. London has possession of it now. Just two or three more clears, and the Adrian College Bulldogs will be out of the woods with their respective penalties. It came at a premium. Hayward trying to get the shorthanded goal, trying to go deep into the slot. Nothing doing right there. Excellent defense by the Spartans. Knapp has it at the top of the zone. Trying to go deep into the faceoff circle. Loses possession of it now. Poke check away by the Michigan State Spartans. Now they have possession of it now. And the Bulldogs are back at full strength. We are back to 5-on-5 hockey. Zelmanski checks back into it. Going deep in the slot. Going for the backhander. Comes up empty. As it looks like Poland was able to hold on to the puck. Oh no! It looks like they scored on there. And right now, Poland is not happy with the call. So it's 4-2, Michigan State Spartans. That was the most confusing, depleted, non-energetic goal I've ever seen because referees called that kind of late. Absolute bedlam in front of the crease. And it's going to be 4-2, still in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. 11:05 remaining in period number two. And being credited for the goal was Barbola. Riles it around. Bulldogs able to just hit it away. Poles has possession of it now, losing it. Going back to the Adrian College Bulldogs in their defensive zone, takes it below Poland. Yeah, going back to that goal, kind of reminds me of Patrick Gaines' game-winning goal a few years ago. Going deep in the zone, goes for the backhander. That would have been a nice play by Britt Levisser right there. Comes up empty, couldn't get it through. But as I was saying, that goal by the Michigan State Spartans reminds me of Patrick Kane's game-winning goal against the Philadelphia Flyers back in 2010 in Game 7 when he was able to get the game winner and the Blackhawks were able to become Stanley Cup champions. But no one knew that Kane got it in, not even Doc Emmerich. And Doc Emmerich was continuing the call, but it was over. The Blackhawks were Stanley Cup champions right there. As glove saved by Lucia, as a few players go flying. So, yeah, the Spartans goal kind of reminds me of that, where it just looked like I was just continuing the play, saying Poland held on to it, and we were going to get ready for the faceoff, but nothing doing right there. 4-2. Faceoff in the southeast part of the rink, knocking it away. Having possession of it right now are the Adrian College Bulldogs. Rybal has possession of it. It's going to be 2-on-2. Lets one fire off the chest protector of Lucia. She was looking into her glove to see if she had the puck. She did not. Goes back to the point area, and the Bulldogs are able to knife at it. Rybal just trying to hit it in. Bigman loses possession of the puck. It's going down the other way. Scarborough is going to take possession of it on the stick side of Poland. We have 9:20 remaining in period number two. Shots on goal differential, 21-17 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. They lead 4-2. Rybal drops it on back to Robinson. Trying to get there on the rebound. Lucia made a terrible leg pad stop, left herself very vulnerable. And the Bulldogs weren't able to capitalize on there, but they capitalized right there and they score! Late reaction by Lucia. Credit that goal to number 17, Kensney Heiser. Let's look at the replay. Heisner didn't even need to make much of an effort. Saw an opening right there, and time just slowed down for her, able to get it past Lucia. 5-2, Adrian College. Face off at center ice. And it's going to go over to the Michigan State Spartans. Lotek tries to swipe it away. There to help her out is Chase. Goes into neutral zone. Lotek loses possession of the puck. Chase has it now. Pitching on back to Lotek. Loses possession of it. Goes back to Paul. Poland raising her hand, warning her team of the icing. Icing is the call. Knapp got there first to defense. So we are going to go into the defensive zone for the Michigan State Spartans and get ready for the faceoff. If you're looking to blame for the icing origination, you can thank the Boston Bruins and the New York Americans. Obviously, the Boston Bruins are still around, but the New York Americans are no longer. Originated in 1931 when they would just blast the puck down the rink just to annoy one another. League officials had to create the rule to tell them to just knock it off and say this is nonsensical way to play the game of hockey. Zelmensky has possession of it now. Trips on her own skates in neutral zone, but able to pitch it over to Knapp. Knapp dishing off ahead to Rotundo. And there's going to be a line change, or I thought there was going to be. Bulldogs elect not to go for it, as it looked like Rotundo was about to come off the rink. So Bulldogs are going to remain with the same unit. Spartans have possession of it now in neutral zone. 7:55 remaining in period number two, excuse me. Going deep into the zone. Looking to go for the backhander. Poland loses possession of it, and she's able to regain it. Going back to the penalty box is the Adrian College Bulldogs, as it's going to be on Knapp. And interference is the call on her. Unfortunately, she didn't allow the player to get involved in the play. You cannot do that. That will result in an interference call each time. So another power play opportunity for the Michigan State Spartans. They have not been able to capitalize on any of the power play opportunities given to them. And yet they still trail by 3 goals. And they have 2 on the board. And they are both at even strength. Bulldogs are just handing them power play opportunities. But they cannot capitalize. Garrett loses possession of it. Hayward trying to challenge. Goes back to the Michigan State Spartans. Having control of it in neutral zone. Able to knife it away. Hitting up on ahead. Goes into defensive zone for the Michigan State Spartans. Glim has it. Trying to center off a pass. And it's going to go to Allie Van Twerp. And there's the icing call. We are going down the other way of the rink for a faceoff. 7:07 remaining in period number two. We still have 20 minutes of hockey remaining in the final period of regulation. A minute 26 remaining in Knapp's penalty. Faceoff coming in the southwest part of the rink. Vanatwerp hits a little too wide for Lucia to do anything with it. Hayward just hitting it in. Vanatwerp has possession of it now. Goes a little too wide. Hayward has it now. Goes into the safety netting here at Arrington Ice Arena. So we are going to reset with the faceoff. A minute 06 remaining in Knapp's penalty for her interference call. I don't know the exact number, but the Bulldogs have been in the penalty a lot. At one point, they had three girls in the penalty box. Going back to the Adrian College Bulldogs, Leviser lets one fire off the protector, trying to get there on the rebound and try to get the shorthanded goal. Comes up unsuccessful. Leviser has it now for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Skating it around. Tries to shoot one. Getting there on the rebound. They are swarming Lucia right now. Wraparound shot. Can she get it through? No, she cannot. Lucia is going to hold on to it. Forty-four seconds remaining in period number two. And it's going to go to the Michigan State Spartans trying to clear the zone. Knocking it down was Scarborough. 35 seconds remaining in Knapp's penalty. Leviser is going to try again with the wraparound shot. She scores! Second goal this afternoon for Britt Leviser, the senior. At first, when you don't succeed, try, try, and try again. Leviser finally gets her second goal of the game. She was determined to do so as we look on the replay. Just goes for the wraparound shot. Lucia had no answer for her, and the Bulldogs get the shorthanded goal. Knapp still has spent another 30 seconds in the penalty box. But the Spartans are still unable to capitalize on any power play opportunities. Britt Leviser has been aggressive all game for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Stevens has possession of it, excuse me. Dumps it in. Goes back over to Massapus. Massapus has possession of it. Pass center ice past the blue line. Greeted by Vanatwerp. Wore that puck. And the Bulldogs are back at full strength. Knapp checks back into the game. Shoots one in. Unsuccessful. Easy come, easy go. Bulldogs once again go back to the penalty box as it's going to be a cross-checking on number 9, Vanatwerp. How many times have I said this afternoon, and we still have one more period to go after this? The Bulldogs are once again in the penalty, and the Spartans are once again in the power play opportunity. Just a few moments ago, Britt Leviser got a shorthanded goal.
Asian College penalty at 14:26 in the second period. Nine,
Spartans have possession of it.
2 minutes for cross-checking.
Back over to Massapus, trying to knock it down. Holding on to it is Poland. Nothing getting past in her country. So we're going to try again with a face-off. .145 remaining in Vanatwerp's penalty. Spartans have possession of it all alone. Let's one fire, knocked down by Poland. Fishing for the puck. Poland is going to land onto it, hold on to it. And we have 5:02 remaining in period number two. We have another faceoff. Shots on goal differential, 25-22 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. And 90 seconds remaining in Vanatwerp's penalty for cross-checking. Face-off in the north side of the rink. It's going to go over to the Spartans. No one is there on the rebound, and no one can go backdoor on Poland. Spartans have possession of it. Knocks it down. Knifing at it. Having possession of it is Hayward. Dumps the puck in. That will kill some time. Line change of specialty teams for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Spartans have possession of it now. Trying to clear it and go back on the attack because they have 55 seconds remaining on their respective power play. Past the blue line. Zelmensky has it. Goes deep in the zone. Direct strike at Lucia. Lucia was not going to let this puck go past her and get another shorthanded goal. 4:18 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs on top by a score of 6-2. 45 seconds remaining in Van Antwerp's penalty. On the glove side for Lucia in the south side of the rink, near the penalty box of Adrian College, it's going to go to the Spartans. Massapus is able to hit it up ahead to Borbala. Now Rowe has it. Knocked away and it goes to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Chase has it. Getting chased right now, no pun intended. Going deep in the zone, tries to go for the backhander. And Massapus is able to play excellent defense and to prevent that from happening as they go crashing into the boards in the south side of the rink. Center try, goes back door, they score! Another shorthanded goal for the Adrian College Bulldogs with 13 seconds to spare with Knapp being in the penalty box. Going back door was their captain, number 22, Hannah Chase. Excellent defense, but just better offense. Spartans were just playing aggressive those last few moments, but unfortunately, they let up an opening, and the Bulldogs played smart and were able to get it past Lucia once again for the seventh time this afternoon. 3:35 remaining in period number two. Bulldogs are right now putting Shaka Zulu's Iwisa on Michigan State University by a score of 7-2. 3:25 remaining in period number two. Swiping it away. Goes back to the Adrian College Bulldogs. Rattles it around. Levasseur. Hayward. Rocking some blue hair, as I mentioned, in period number one. She's known for that. Knocked down by the Spartans. Wore that puck beautifully. Let's one fire. Goes a little too wide. Scarborough hustling for the puck. She takes it deep into the south part of the rink. Scarborough about to run into the referee. He gets out of the way quickly. Hustling for the puck in the southwest corner as it is jammed right now. Trying to pitch it up ahead to Poles. We're going to get a whistle. Cross-checking on Regner. And another power play opportunity for the Michigan State Spartans. However, they have led up two shorthanded goals to this Bulldog roster. So they have come up unsuccessful in any power play opportunity presented to them. Van Antwerp has possession of it now. Takes it below Poland. So Regner for the second time this afternoon is in the penalty box. And a minute 45 remaining in the penalty for the Adrian College Bulldogs, hustling for the puck. It's going to be a foot race. Rybel and Paul hustling for it. They are going to take it into neutral zone. Are the Spartans passing up ahead? Bulldogs able to clear it. Massapos has possession of it in neutral zone. Hits it over to Van Antwerp. 2 minutes remaining in period number two. A minute 22 remaining in the penalty for Regner. And having control of it now is Massapus. But stalking in is Rybel for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Crawford has to clank it off the boards and try to give it off in neutral zone to avoid the offsides. Going deep into the zone, lets one fire. Goes a little too high as looks like a Spartans defender was able to get a stick on it. A minute 20 remaining in period number two. Shots on goal, differential 28-23 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. 40 seconds remaining in their penalty. Losing possession of the puck. It's going to go back to the Spartans. Having possession of it now is Garrett. Dumps it in. 55 seconds remaining in period number two. 20 seconds remaining in the penalty for Regner. Let's one go. And it goes a little too wide. Poland didn't even need to make any some sort of a stop. Centering try. Bulldogs are going to be able to clear the puck and kill some more time as the penalty kill will be successful once again for the Adrian College Bulldogs as Regner checks back into the game. Bulldogs are back at full strength. Regner tries to lay one off for Levisser. Levisser takes control of it in the south side of the rink. Poking at it as the puck is pinned near the southeast corner. Spartans have possession of it. 10 seconds remaining in period number two. It's going to be 3-on-2. Let's one go off the padding of Victoria Poland. Passing it around. Misses Regner. Bulldogs trying to clear it. And Levisser was going to try to corral the puck. But unfortunately, time was not on her side as the puck and the time wound down. So it's been all Bulldogs this afternoon. Been all Bulldogs this afternoon as they lead by a score of 7-2, and they are going to be headed to the locker room to get replenished, refueled, and rehydrated for the final period of regulation. Michigan State Spartans have some work to do if they want to claw their way back into the game. Referees also coming to center ice to discuss. So coaches will go over their respective game plan. And players are once again slow to get off the rink as the Bulldogs are still remaining on their benches, not heading to the locker room yet. Now they do so. So we will step aside on Adrian College Television on YouTube for Caitlin Parisi, my director, and also our top cam operator. We will catch you at the beginning of period number three. Don't go anywhere.
The Adrian College Media Production House provides opportunities for students to learn and grow live on the airwaves, just like Matt Kibbe.
I've gotten a chance to create a relationship with coaches and teams and learn more from people instead of trying to teach myself something. Got an opportunity to expand my knowledge of sports, hone in on my skills as a broadcaster, and learn about equipment in different ways. You get more of a connection with professors as well.
Providing opportunities, growing leadership. The Adrian College Media Production House. Thanks for tuning in.
Adrian College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit AdrianBulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time.
If there was one word I was going to use to describe the communication arts program at Adrian College, it would be unique. Students find themselves on the radio, in front of and behind the camera, and directing their own programs. Students learn in a personalized environment that sets them up for a world of opportunities. Are you ready for your moment in the limelight? Learn more about the Rush Communications Center and Adrian College's communications program
by visiting adrian.edu today. Want to learn more about Adrian College Television? To find out more about ACTV, you can visit our website at adriancollege.tv. You can find direct links to our Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and other social media platforms there. Bulldog students can submit a request to become an announcer for ACTV. Fans can see press releases about upcoming events and what's happening at the media production house. Visit adriancollege.tv for more.
Oh, hey, there he is, Bruiser. Hi, I'm Bruiser's biggest fan. He was a legend to us puppies.
Strong but silent. Such a humble attitude from such a prominent figure.
He ran Adrian College's campus. Everyone loved him and wanted to meet him wherever he went. Welcome week, homecoming, spring concert, he was there and looking good. Well, he did have his own private groomer. He was so cool. He had the best education a bulldog could ever ask for, as many walks as he wanted. Heck, the dog had his own Pastor Richie. Bruiser was an athlete, but I'm so small. He did have to work hard at it. Well, maybe not too hard, but it will take a lot of commitment and practice. I want to land on varsity at Arrington, too. It's just such a big jersey to fill. Seriously, huge. But I can do this. I want the job. Because I want to make thousands of Bulldog friends just like him. So hi, Adrian College. I'm Bruiser, too.
Time I'd like to introduce President Docking.
16 years I've been doing this, saying hello to freshman groups coming in. But obviously this one's different. The friends that you're going to make, the experiences that you're going to have, the memories that you will create are just amazing.
This is gonna be the best day of my life.
Adrian College's 2020-2021 enrollment has set a new record at 1,865 students. The incoming freshman class of 602 new students helped set the new record. This is the 13th consecutive year the Bulldogs have had an incoming class of more than 500 freshmen. Nearly 6,000 high school seniors applied to attend Adrian College this fall. Why do so many students choose Adrian? Adrian is constantly expanding majors offered to incoming freshmen. If you're a high schooler or know someone who is looking at taking their education to the next level, AC could be the answer. To see the programs Adrian offers, learn more about the process, schedule a visit, and even apply today, visit adrian.edu/admissions. adrian.edu/admissions. We look forward to seeing you on campus.
Want to see the Adrian College Outdoor Performance Band in action? The band performed on Adrian College TV, and you can watch the stream again anytime, anywhere. Professional audio technician Christopher Momini beautifully captured the event, and you can listen to the entire performance now. Visit Adrian College TV on YouTube to listen to the concert.
Welcome to Adrian, Michigan. We're located in a proud college town. Adrian College is situated just 45 minutes from Ann Arbor, Detroit, and Toledo. We're very excited to show you just a little bit of what AC has to offer. This is the gateway to our campus. Welcome to the place that we believe will change the rest of your life. AC features one of the most well-rounded educational experiences in the country. We offer over 60 different academic majors and 10 academic institutes, as well as dozens of student organizations. Year after year, we've been ranked as one of the nation's best colleges, including being one of the most innovative institutions in the U.S. for our medical programs. Our campus is simply beautiful. Our student-to-faculty ratio is an incredible 13-1. That means more attention for you and a much better overall learning environment. We know how to put together an education that is life-changing, and these are just some of the highlights. From our communication arts program, to our many performing arts, to the home of business on campus, to our sciences and medical studies, we have the spaces where you can grow into the professional that you want to become. Our first-year student experience is award-winning. You'll make lifelong friends here, meet mentors, and maybe even meet that special someone. The Kane Student Center is open 24 hours a day, and there's a lot going on here. The Bulldog Beanery has all of your hot drinks. Pause and Go is our on-campus convenience store. The bookstore is where you'll get all of your Bulldog gear, and you can just hang out and study in the skyboxes. Not far away is the Shipman Library. The Shipman has quiet, relaxing spaces for you to study in. You can check out books from thousands of libraries around the country, and the Shipman is open 24 hours as well for your convenience. There are hundreds of learning opportunities on campus. In addition to the arts and beautiful facilities, Adrian College is known for its athletic programs. There is nothing like a Saturday game day here in Adrian. The Bulldog football team are 11-time MIAA champions. At Docking Stadium, fans watch soccer, lacrosse, football, and more. Just a few hundred yards away, Adrian College's basketball teams compete. In addition to basketball, fans can enjoy wrestling, acro and tumbling, and volleyball here. We also have a state-of-the-art weight room available to all of our students. When things heat up too much on campus, you can cool off with our ice sports. Our NCAA ice hockey teams are constantly battling in the national playoffs. Just a quick walk down the service drive, we feature one of the best baseball and softball programs in the nation at our level. Soon, you'll be able to cross the street and watch men's and women's rugby take to the pitch as well. Our rowing, crew, and top-ranked bass fishing programs compete out of the Adrian College Boathouse, a gorgeous facility just a 15-minute drive north on Devil's Lake. Our students know how to relax in their downtime. When they're not out and about, we have dozens of housing options on campus. With apartments right in the mix of things, you can pick what works best for you. We've also recently renovated a few of our housing options. Adrian College is a Methodist-affiliated institution that has been changing lives since 1859. The modern liberal arts education offered by our faculty is unrivaled. We can't wait to have you on campus and show you around. Visit adrian.edu to schedule a full campus visit today. We'll see you soon.
Welcome back to Arrington Ice Arena, where we're about to begin the final period of regulation. Players, coaches are refueled, rehydrated, and ready to start this final period of regulation. Thank you for tuning in, Adrian College Television on YouTube. Joining me by my left is Delaney Harris, our top cam operator. First day at ACTV. Welcome to the family, as I stated, along with Kayla Parisi, my director. And there's actually going to be a goalie swap for the Adrian College Bulldogs. So subbing in for Victoria Poland is senior number 29, Gabby Warwick. So it's nice to see that the coaching staff for the Adrian College Bulldogs are trying to give all their seniors their final reps and their final salute here at Arrington Ice Arena. Victoria Poland did one heck of a job this game. She saw 24 shots and was able to stop two of them. She was able to stop 22 of them, and two were able to go past her. So 22 for 24 out of save opportunities. And Lucia will still remain the starting netminder for the Michigan State Spartans to begin period number three. So Lucia is in the north side of the rink, and Warwick is in the south side. As there's going to be a line change as Lucia held on to the puck. And the clock is still going. I don't know why they're not stopping it right now. But yeah, it is senior day here at Arrington Ice Arena for this women's D2 team. So, like I said, just great to see that all the seniors are going to be given an opportunity just to salute the fans and just say so long for their years of dedication and hard work for this great sport that they so love very much. Puck goes down the other way. It's going to be on the stick side of Warwick. Referees are going to wave off the icing call as Knapp regains control of it. Passing up ahead. Knapp has it. Past the blue line. Shoots one in. They're on the rebound. They can't get it through. Another opportunity where Lucia lost possession of the puck. And the Bulldogs were trying to get there on the rebound as there's some extracurricular activity going on near the northeast corner. Line change for the Adrian College Bulldogs as Zelminski and Knapp will be subbed off. Faceoff coming in neutral zone in front of the Michigan State Sparts benches. Heisner has possession of it. Back on down. Back over to Heisner. Weak stick. Too much traffic in the lane. Scarborough can't poke check it away. And this time she is able to do so. Takes it into the southwest corner. Rattles it around. It's going to go back over to Droba. Goes back into the southeast corner. Trying to play it out front near the crease area. London has possession of it now for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Passing up ahead to Droba. Two on one. Odd man rush. This could be trouble. Leviser has possession of it now. Looking for the hat trick. Back on down to Droba. They're on the rebound. Can they try to get it? No, they cannot. Lucia is going to land on her stomach, land on the puck, and that's going to freeze action. Words being exchanged right now. It's getting chippy here at Arrington Ice Arena. That was probably out of frustration. Going to the penalty box is Crawford. It's going to be 2 minutes for roughing. And it's also going to be on Britt Levisser too, as she's going to be spending 2 minutes in the penalty box for roughing as well for that recent exchange of punches. And it's going to go below the goal line with 6:20 remaining in period number three. Off the leg padding. So 4-on-4 hockey here at Arrington Ice Arena. Another opportunity where the Bulldogs head into the penalty box, but this time the Spartans are right there with them. So neither team is at full strength, but neither team is in the power play. Bulldogs on top by a score of 7-2 with 15:55 remaining in period number three. Going down the other way. Goes top shelf. She scores and makes this 8-2. And a little bit of a shove right there. Hayward knocks her to the ground with her stick. Frustration right now for the Spartans and the Bulldogs. Getting chippy right now. Hayward is going to the penalty box. You cannot do that. As Regner celebrates right now. But right now, it's getting absolute chaotic here at Arrington Ice Arena. And it looks like Hayward might be hitting the showers early. Referees discussing with the Adrian College Bulldogs. Yeah, so the Bulldogs score a goal, but unfortunately some shoves were being exchanged by both respective teams. Hayward got the finisher by knocking a Spartans player down to the ground on her back with her stick. So with that penalty, Hayward could be heading to the locker rooms. So Samantha Lotek will be serving the penalty. And what a way to go during your senior night, getting ejected. So, yeah, Samantha Lotek is heading to the penalty box to serve it for Hayward. So it's going to be 4-on-3, and they got to fix the penalty box times as it was continuing to go. The clock was still continuing to go. No one was paying attention. Wait, it's wrong right now. They got to fix that quickly. As there was a break in the action, it was continuing to go. I don't know what to think. But Lotek is spending the next 4 minutes and 40 seconds in the penalty box for that major. And I think that's the last of we'll see of Katie Hayward this evening. Levisser fishing it out. She has control of it but lands on her stomach. Out of the zone. Spartans are going to have to come back and reset. 8-2 in period number three. Goes high of the crossbar, off the glass, almost hit the safety netting, but the referees are going to let the girls continue to play. Levisser dropping on back to Knapp, losing possession of it, and it's going to be passed up ahead. London greeting Garrett. London going deep in his zone, goes a little too wide of the post. Excellent opportunity right there, but unfortunately, just a little too much muster on it. Knapp has possession of it, rattles it around. And it's going to go over to Levisser in neutral zone, but the Bulldogs are going to have to come back and reset. Still 5-on-4 hockey. Spartans just trying to capitalize. They have come up unsuccessful in all power play opportunities this evening. Warwick directing her teammates right now of where the puck is. Knapp has possession of it as the puck is pinned along the boards near the southeast corner. We have 12:50 remaining in period number three. So, yeah, going back to those penalties where it was 4-on-4 for a second, and, yep, we're getting another whistle. Oh, man. Oh, no, unsportsmanlike conduct. And it's going on Zelmanski as she said an expletive towards the referees. Let's just say she might have told the referee to leave her alone. In a not-so-nice way. So, yeah, another three girls in the penalty box once again for the Adrian College Bulldogs. So this is 5-on-3 hockey for the second time this afternoon. 11:55 remaining in the final period of regulation. And passing up the rink. Chase going past the blue line. And the puck is going to go near the bench for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Van Antwerp has possession of it now. Cross pass over to Stevens. Stevens is just going to dump the puck as she's going to clear it to kill some time. Obviously some frustrations in the penalty box for the Adrian College Bulldogs despite being up 8-2. 11:15 remaining in the final period of regulation. Thank you for tuning in to Adrian College Television on YouTube. I'm Trey Matthews, your play-by-play announcer. To my right is Caitlin Parisi, the director, doing a heck of a job. And also doing one heck of a job on her first day is Delaney Harris, the top cam operator. Paul knocked down by the Adrian College Bulldogs. Stevens able to knife at it and fish it out. Going down the other way. Spartans can corral it. With 10:45 remaining in period number three, shots on goal differential 33-25 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Trying to go deep into the zone. Knapp loses possession of it. Going back to the Spartans. Knifing at it. And Rybol checks back into the game, serving a penalty for one of her teammates. As Zelmanski has to spend 10 minutes in the penalty box for unsportsmanlike conduct. So just getting a sub in. So it was pretty interesting. Zelmanski was assigned a 10-minute misconduct. So someone else on her team had to serve the 2 minutes. And now the Bulldogs have 5-on-4. And Lotek is serving Hayward's penalty for that hit. And Lotek checks back into the game, so the Bulldogs are back at full strength here at Arrington Ice Arena. But still in the penalty box for a good amount of time and probably won't see her for the rest of the game is Zelmanski due to her exchanging some words between the Spartans and the referees. Spartans passing up ahead to Merriman. Bulldogs just trying to hit it ahead. Lotek has possession of it now. To her left is Knapp. Right in front of her is Heisner. Heisner, the one of the alternate captains for this Adrian College Bulldog team, has possession of it. Going past the blue line. Centering try. And unfortunately, Robinson couldn't do anything with it. Jabbing at it is Scarborough. Lotek trying to poke check the puck away in the northeast corner. She shoves a player really hard. No penalty will be assigned. 8:45 remaining in period number three. Bulldogs hustling for the puck, and they lose possession of it now. Back over to the Spartans, trying to pass it up ahead. In their defensive zone are the Adrian College Bulldogs looking to clear it and go back on the attack. Scarborough has possession of it now. To her right is Heisner, Robinson, and also Leviser, who just checked back into the game. 8:25 remaining in period number three. Bulldogs are right now toppling the Michigan State Spartans by a score of 8-2. Spartans have possession of it. Weak stick goes wide of Warwick. Doesn't even need to make a stop. Warwick has only faced one shot in the entire third period regulation. 2-on-1, odd man rush. Bulldogs looking to capitalize on it. The netting gets messed up. And the referees, we're going to have to call timeout. Interference will be the call. And that's going to go on the alternate captain for the Michigan State Spartans. A two-minute minor. And it's going to go on Borbala. Borbala has scored one of the two goals for the Michigan State Spartans this afternoon. I don't know why they are beginning the penalty box so early. The referees haven't even begun action. So Borbala, instead of spending 2 minutes, she gets a 10-second shaved off of her penalty. And we are going to get a whistle. 7-12 remaining in period number three. Bulldogs on top by a score of 8-2. They must really want to speed along this game because they are not stopping the clocks despite a pause in action. But I guess they just want to speed the game along. I don't know what the case might be, but, you know, right now, Borbala is spending less time in the penalty box than she should. 2-on-1, Amir Rush rattles around the post and comes out on the rebound. Direct strike at Lucia. By the time we get another puck drop, it will be 6:30 remaining in period number three as the clock continues to go. I have never seen this before. I have never seen this before in all my time of calling college hockey. I've never seen the clock being so continuous. The only sport I see the clock being continuous, no matter what, is the sport of soccer. Bulldogs there on the rebound. Knapp trying to give it down low at the point area. 25 seconds remaining in the penalty kill for the Spartans. Bulldogs right now trying to collapse the defense and trying to get the power play goal. The Bulldogs have a couple shorthanded goals this afternoon. Knapp's shot goes a little too wide and knocked down in traffic below the goal line. 5:44 remaining in the final period of regulation. And right now, just passing up ahead are the Adrian College Bulldogs. A lot of Spartans there to greet them. Can they try to collapse the defense? That would have been one heck of a shot right there. Centering try with all the girls in green swarming the girls in yellow. But nothing doing right there. The puck goes down the other way. And icing is the call. Warwick did not raise her hand to warn London of it, but I guess since London was going to get there in plenty of time due to a line change for the Michigan State Spartans, I guess there was no need. Warwick has only faced one shot still in the final period of regulation. Victoria Poland began two-thirds of this game, facing 24 shots and saving 22 of them. Knocked down in traffic. And I'm also getting word that the Adrian College Bulldogs D2 team will still have a couple more games here at Eric Tadice Arena. However, it will be against a couple of travel teams. And obviously, everything with how everything is going on right now, is everything is still up in the air. Nothing is still set in stone. But still, anticipate for the women's D2 team to have just a couple more games even after their senior night. Hustling for the puck. It's going to go to the Spartans. Spartans at this point trying to save face. Knifing at it. Bigman is able to jab it over to Robinson. 4 minutes remaining in period number three. Hustling down. Scarborough has possession of it now. 3-on-2 in favor of the Spartans. Now going back down the other way. Glim has it. And Warwick is going to hold on to it, land onto the puck, hit very weakly. Not a hard stop to make, so we are going to try again with a faceoff. With, once again, the clock continuing to go. On the bright side, it makes it easier for my director, Caitlin Parisi. And it looks like a false start. So we are going to try again in the faceoff circle on the glove side of Warwick near the southwest corner here at Arrington. 3 minutes remaining in period number three, the final period of regulation. Let's one fire, knocked down by Rybel. Spartans are going to try again at the point. Paul Knocked down by the Adrian College Bulldogs. Stevens couldn't corral it, though. Poles has it. At the point. Spartans can't do anything with it. Now going back down the other way. 3-on-2 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Odd man rush. Lets one fire. And almost rattled in as it went off the glove of Lucia. Bulldogs just looking for that final goal. As this one is already pretty much put away. But it's still nice to just put that final nail in the coffin. And now the faceoff coming in the north side of the rink. 2 minutes remaining in period number three. Shots on goal differential, 38-26 in favor of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Facing the puck, hitting it into neutral zone. 1:50 remaining in period number three. Levisser looking for the hat trick this evening. Going past the blue line, greeted by excellent defense by the Spartans. Having control of it was Barbola, who was there to smother her. Now back at the point, and the Bulldogs are going to lose control of it. Goes into neutral zone. Knapp waiting for teammates to come back and reset. Waiting for Levisser to go past the blue line into neutral zone. She does so. Looking to reset. Lets one fire. And it goes a little too wide. Look good from up here. 1:15 remaining in the final period of regulation in this puck affair. Having control of it right now is Merriman. Going past the blue line. Bulldogs looking for an opening. Lets one fire. Can they get there on the rebound? They cannot. Spartans are able to control it. Going deep on the zone. Trying to go for the backhander. Lucia is able to win this battle this time around as Adrian College Bulldogs cannot trickle up past her. Line change for the Adrian College Bulldogs. We have 30 seconds remaining in period number three. Now going down to 25. Wrestling for the puck. And they are going to lose control of it, and it's going to go back to the Spartans. Cross it over to Garrett. Garrett wide open. Trying to go top shelf on Warwick, but she's able to knock it down. Probably the hardest shot that Warwick had to face. Now going down the other way. Heisner has possession of it. Goes for the backhander as she was shoved right there. And the Bulldogs come out victorious in this game. Regner was on the breakaway, had a wide open opportunity. But the Spartans were saying, you are not going to get this last second goal and make this a 9-2 game. The Bulldogs will come out victorious on their senior night by a score of 8-2. Again, a special thanks to Victoria Polden, Gabby Warwick, Katie Hayward, Tina Rotolo, Hannah Regner, Kenzie Heisner, Haley Bigham, Liz Anderson, Hannah Chase, the captain, and Britt Levisser. Honoring you guys during your senior night. Thank you for your hard work, determination, sweat, blood, and tears as the Bulldogs absolutely clobber the Michigan State Spartans by a score of 8-2. Just a high-scoring game. As the Bulldogs salute their fans at center ice, it is time for us to say so long. So for Caitlin Parisi, the director, and we will have highlights after this game, so stick around. For Caitlin Parisi, the director, and also Ms. Harris, our top cam operator, thank you for joining your first game. Delaney Harris, I apologize. I am terrible with names. So I'm Trey Matthews, play-by-play announcer, and we will say so long. To the ground. No penalties will be assigned. Bulldogs have possession of it now. Up to Hayward, past the blue line, going deep into the slot. Let's one fire. She scores! Bulldogs will strike first. Here on Adrian, and Twerp has possession of it now at the point area for the Adrian College Bulldogs. Droba trying to look for some space, going deep in the zone, tries to go through the 5-0, she scores! Lucia thought she was able to hold on to the puck. Has it for the Michigan State Spartans. Stevens trying to fish it out. One-on-one, lets one fire. She shoots it in and she scores! Fooled Poland right there was Wagner. Stevens is able to swipe it away. Stevens trying to pass it up ahead to Druba. Druba able to maneuver it over to Hayward. Hayward lets one fire. On the rebound, they score! And they are glad to have her right now as she has been putting up a great amount of points in just limited games played. Playing it out in front, trying to get there on the rebound. They score once again! 4-1 Adrian College Bulldogs. Lucia made a terrible leg pad stop, left herself very vulnerable, and the Bulldogs weren't able to capitalize on there, but they capitalized right there and they score! Late reaction by Lucia. Knocking it down was Scarborough. 35 seconds remaining in Knapp's penalty. Levisser is going to try again with the wraparound shot. She scores! Second goal this afternoon for Britt Levisser, the senior. To prevent that from happening as they go crashing into the boards in the south side of the rink. Centering try, goes back door. They score! Another shorthanded goal for the Adrian College Bulldogs. 7-2 with 15:55 remaining in period number three. Going down the other way. Goes top shelf. She scores and makes this 8-2. A little bit of a shove right there. Hayward.
Want to learn more about Adrian College Television? To find out more about ACTV, you can visit our website at adriancollege.tv. You can find direct links to our Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and other social media platforms there. Bulldog students can submit a request to become an announcer for ACTV. Fans can see press releases about upcoming events and what's happening at the media production house. Visit adriancollege.tv for more.
Adrian College has dozens of athletics programs, and winning is a staple on our campus. We have the culture of winning in and out of the classroom. This is a place where young men and women grow into professionals for life. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit adrianbulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time. Are you looking to continue your athletic career while also pursuing your educational career? Adrian College houses dozens of varsity and club programs right here on campus, along with 77 undergraduate degrees and 47 majors. Are you interested in learning more about the Bulldog experience? Visit adrianbulldogs.com and the Recruit Me tab to be recruited to play your sport of choice today. If you have what it takes, you could be a Bulldog in no time. Adrian College is a pinpoint like no other. With our 77 undergraduate degrees, 47 majors, and 21 broad fields of study, Adrian has a one-of-a-kind, hands-on learning experience for everyone. Do you want to visit the campus of Adrian College in person? Visit adrian.edu/campus-visit. Again, that's adrian.edu/campus-visit. Come take in the beautiful facilities at Adrian College for yourself.
I'm Matt Kibbe, the current student body president here at Adrian College. I chose AC because the campus simply feels like home. Everywhere I go, I know the amenities are there to help me succeed and get to the next level in my career. If you want to see what Adrian College has to offer, you can schedule an in-person visit at adrian.edu/campus-visit.
We
look forward to seeing you on campus.
The Adrian College Sports Network wants you to join us in thanking one of our sponsors, the Carlton Lodge of Adrian. The Carlton Lodge offers a comfortable and convenient lodging experience. Carlton has spacious rooms and suites. fit for a peaceful night's sleep. Their amenities include a hot tub and pool, a 24-hour fitness center, a business center, and much more. A huge thanks to Adrian College's Choice of Lodging for sponsoring Bulldog Athletics.